But everyone didn't realize that Norman and George were in the helicopter all on their own, and they weren't supposed to be. "Uh-oh," said Norman. "I think Sam can see us." And Sam said, "Wait, Norman, don't go anywhere. Stop right there," said Sam. But Norman had already started the helicopter's engine, and off they went, up into the sky. "Hold on," said Norman. Finally, Norman landed the plane safely. This meant they were in some serious trouble in the Pontypandy fire station, and Marshall, Tom Thomas and Fireman Sam weren't happy with Norman and George. They said, "What was you thinking? You guys could have got in some serious trouble then. You could have crashed. You could even be in hospital." And Norman said, "It's okay. I've watched you thousands of times drive in this helicopter, Sam. I know exactly what to do," as he ran away. And Sam said, "Come back." And Norman came back. He said, "You may know what to do, Norman, but that doesn't mean you qualify to drive such a heavy piece of machinery like a helicopter." And Marshall and Tom Thomas said, "You guys need to be very careful in future and never use the helicopter without us again." "Okay." And they both said sorry. So the moral of the story is, you shouldn't use someone else's helicopter without using them. And if you do, make sure you're safe. "Don't forget to subscribe," said Sam. Fireman Sam was at the fire station, and he had phoned Peppa and George to come over. And he's bought Peppa and George these cool Chupa Chups with a cool surprise inside. It says Sticky Zoo on the front. And Sam can't wait to show George and Peppa what he's got him. So George says, "Hey Sam, what are these big toys you got?" And Peppa said, "Wow, you know how much I love the Chupa Chups lollies." And Sam said, "They're for you guys, you got one each, and they come with surprises as well." "That's pretty cool," said George. "Can we open them?" "Of course you can," said Fireman Sam. "Who wants to open one first?" said Sam. So George steps forward and says, "I'll open one first, Peppa, if you don't mind." And George and Sam were really excited to see what there was in the Chupa Chups. So as we can see, it says Sticky Zoo on the front, Chupa Chups, and I wonder what's inside. So you get the lolly and the surprise. So let's open it and see what we find. So with a helping hand, George opens his cool Chupa Chup surprise. And he said, "Wow, look at that, it's the same color as my t-shirt, look. It's blue." So inside, we get a cool little surprise. "And it's a little seahorse," said George. "How cool is that? And he's blue, like my t-shirt. That's really cool." And they got little stickers underneath. And George can't believe how big this little seahorse is. He said, "Look, it's nearly as big as me." "Don't forget your little lolly," said Sam. So George was really excited because he got a cool seahorse and a really nice strawberry lolly. So the collection is full of creatures from the zoo. Peppa said, "Come on, George, move out of the way. Let me open my one. Let me see what I got." And Peppa was hoping to get the same coloured animal as her t-shirt. How cool would that be? So with a helping hand, we opened the surprise egg again. "And wow," said Peppa. "I think it's a crab. How cool is that?" "Wow, you got a cool crab. That's a white colour. And it has really cool little eyes. And you also got a strawberry lolly." Strawberry is George's and Peppa's favourite lolly. So Fireman Sam takes a seat and he falls over. He's really excited about these toys today. So George, Peppa, Fireman Sam had a really cool time opening the Chupa Chups surprise toys and lollies at the fire station. Peppa and George will have to take these toys home now and have the lollies at later. And they both said, "Thanks, Sam, for getting us such cool surprises." Peppa Pig and George were playing. And George says to Peppa, "Oh, Peppa, I'd love to go for a ride." And then Peppa turns around and says, "Look, look, look who's coming. It's the Greendale train. And who's on it? We have Fireman Sam's on there and AJ." So Fireman Sam gets off and says, "Hey guys, how are you?" Peppa says, "I'm great, Fireman Sam, thanks." And then George says, "I'm great too." And AJ comes off and says, "Oh, Peppa, how have you been?" And Peppa replies saying, "Wow, your train is looking super clean today." George cheekily jumps on the train and Peppa, messing about, climbs on the back of the train. And then Fireman Sam says, "I can see you." "Oh no, Fireman Sam fell over." Fireman Sam said, "Peppa, try to be careful up there. It's dangerous playing on the back of trains." So AJ comes over and said, "Hey George, shall we all jump on the train?" So George jumps off the train, AJ jumps on and stands inside. So George stands next to AJ, and then Peppa says, "How are we going to fit on there, Fireman Sam? There's no room for us." Fireman Sam said, "I got a cool idea. Hang on. Wait there a second." So Fireman Sam went off to get some Play-Doh. So Fireman Sam said, "We'll put the Play-Doh on the roof, which will allow us to stick to the roof and be super safe. And we'll have a cool seat and a great view." So with a helping hand, the Play-Doh is placed on top of the train from Greendale. So Peppa says, "Let me jump on first, Fireman Sam." So Peppa jumps on the back of the train and sits down at the front, at the top, shortly followed by Fireman Sam. So by using a little bit of Play-Doh, everyone can get on the train safely and we can all have great fun together. So off they go to the Greendale station. "Oh no, we're going the wrong way," said Fireman Sam. "Here we go. Don't forget to subscribe." Fireman Sam and Tom Thomas were outside having a chat. When Fireman Sam said to Tom Thomas, "Peppa's coming round with a new truck today for us to have a look at. I'm going to take me out for a drive. So I can't wait for that." So Tom Thomas gets really excited and says, "Yay, I can't wait to see a new track. I bet it's really cool. So Fireman Sam and Tom Thomas wait and keep waiting. And here she is now. So Peppa comes round in a new fire truck. How cool is that? Peppa said. So Fireman Sam looks, as well as Thomas, says, "Wow, that's a really clean truck you've got there, Peppa." So Peppa gets out with a helping hand and says, "Wow, what do you think of my truck, guys? Go and have a look." So Fireman Sam and Tom Thomas look around the truck and say, "Wow, look at that hose. How cool is that? You've got a fire extinguisher and a bucket on the back. And the ladder could help us get on top. Wow, Peppa fell over." So Peppa shows Fireman Sam how the ladder works. "Come and join me, guys." "Oh, she fell over again. She is way too excited today." "Be careful," said Tom Thomas. So Fireman Sam goes up the ladder and says, "Come on, Thomas, join us up here." So Thomas comes up, looks at the side. "Look at this hose on the side you've got. It's such a long hose," said Tom Thomas. So Fireman comes down the ladder and says, "Come on, Peppa, take me for a drive. Let's see what this baby can do." So Peppa comes down and stands by Fireman Sam. So Peppa gets into the fire engine and is ready to take Fireman Sam on a cool little drive. "Where are we going to go?" Peppa said. So Fireman Sam said, "Let's just go around Pontypandy today and see what we find." So Fireman Sam gets into the fire truck and off they go. And Peppa goes forward and comes right around, leaving Tom Thomas on his own. "But they're coming back," Tom Thomas said. "Right, we're really going now," Peppa said. "Don't forget to subscribe." Fireman Sam, Officer Steel, and Peppa Pig were all at the office. So Fireman Sam said, "Hey Peppa, I'm going to go and do some work on the computer a minute." So Fireman Sam went off to do some work on his little computer. Officer Steel says, "Hey Peppa, don't you think it's about time you put on a fire suit now?" Peppa said, "Oh, I'd love to. Shall I go and get one?" So Peppa got really excited about putting on a cool fireman outfit. Oh no, she fell over in excitement. So Peppa goes off to put on the fire outfit. And he comes back with a cool fireman's outfit on. "How cool is that?" Peppa said. "I look like one of you guys now." "So we're waiting for Tom Thomas to come, and maybe you could go with Tom Thomas, Peppa," said Officer Steele. "Here he is now." So in comes Tom Thomas with his helicopter. "Wow," Peppa said. "How cool is that?" Tom Thomas said, "Hey guys, how are you?" Fireman Sam said, "How are you, Thomas?" "We're great." So Peppa jumps into the helicopter with Tom Thomas and they can go for a cool ride in the helicopter. So Fireman Sam and Officer Steel watched Peppa and Tom Thomas go for a fly in the cool helicopter. "Wow," Peppa said, "this is going to be so much fun." So Fireman Sam and Officer Steel were left at the office, ready for another emergency call if one comes in. So Fireman Sam goes back into the office and Officer Steel follows. "Oh no, Officer Steel fell over. Don't forget to subscribe. Peppa Pig and George were outside the shop. They were just going to get a drink. When Peppa and George spot Fireman Sam. And Fireman Sam was also going for a drink. So Fireman Sam said, "Hey guys, how are you? I suppose you're going in for a drink, are you?" Pepper and George said, "Yeah, let's go in." So Pepper, George and Fireman Sam all went into the shop. And Fireman Sam gets his drink, pays for it. And then he goes outside to wait for Pepper and George. So George goes and gets a drink and says, "Peppa, can you grab the drink up the top for me?" So Peppa goes over to help George. She gets George's drink from the top shelf. And then goes and pays for it. So once they've paid for their drinks, they head back outside. And Fireman Sam says, "Hey guys, where are you off now?" Peppa said, "Grandpa's coming with his train. Do you want to come with us, Fireman Sam?" Fireman Sam said, "That would be great." And George says, "Look, there he is now." So over comes Grandpa with his cool train. So everyone moves out of the way so Grandpa can get past. "Are you going to come with us, Fireman Sam?" Peppa said. Fireman Sam said, "Yeah, I'd love to," and gets really excited. So Fireman Sam waits and jumps in the train. He goes in the yellow carriage at the back. Now it's George's turn. "Go on, George, jump in." So George goes next to Fireman Sam. And then Peppa jumps in the blue carriage at the front. Grandpa says, "Are you all in tight, guys? Let's go." "Oh no, not that way, Grandpa. Let's go forward." So Grandpa Pig, Peppa Pig, George and Fireman Sam all went for a ride in Grandpa's cool train. "Don't forget to subscribe," said Fireman Sam. Tom Thomas and Fireman Sam land Tom Thomas's helicopter. And Fireman Sam said to Tom Thomas, "Tom, what are we doing here?" As Fireman Sam got out of the helicopter, Tom Thomas said, "We're waiting for Peppa to come in a new helicopter that she's just ordered." So Tom Thomas gets out and they both wait for Peppa Pig to come in a new helicopter. So in comes Peppa and Mommy Pig in Peppa's new helicopter. "Wow," Fireman Sam said, "how cool is that? You've got a really cool helicopter, Peppa. It's so much bigger than Tom Thomas's." Peppa said, "Thanks guys, how are you?" Fireman Sam and Tom said, "We're great, thanks for asking." So Mommy Pig takes off his seatbelt and comes out. And she stands out of the way so Fireman Sam and Tom Thomas can have a look around Peppa's new helicopter. "It's so big," Peppa said. "It's going to take me a while to get used to it. But it's really nice." Tom Thomas really likes Peppa's new helicopter and opens the door to have a look inside. "Wow, you've got really cool seatbelts in you, Peppa, to keep you nice and safe," Tom Thomas said. He said, "Fireman Sam, come and have a look at this." So Fireman Sam comes over to have a look around the helicopter as well. And he jumps in the passenger seat and said, "Peppa, are you going to take us for a drive?" So with a helping hand, Fireman Sam put his seatbelt on. Peppa said, Mommy, do you mind if I take Fireman Sam out to show him a new helicopter? And then Mommy Pig said, It's fine, but just don't be too long. You know you got to have your food later. So Peppa got really excited and said, Let's go. So Peppa jumps in to the helicopter and puts her seatbelt on, with a helping hand, of course. You gotta put your seatbelt on to be super safe, especially if you're flying in a helicopter, said Fireman Sam. So Tom Thomas moves out of the way to watch Fireman Sam and Peppa go off into the distance. So where should we go? Fireman Sam said. Let's go to Pontypandy, said Peppa. So Peppa and Fireman Sam both take off in the helicopter. Wow, this is going to be fun, Peppa said. So Mommy Pig and Tom Thomas said, I hope they're both going to be safe. Don't forget to subscribe. Peppa, Fireman Sam and Tom Thomas were outside their new garage. They have all been cleaning the new garage.
The Paw Patrol pups were on the Ocean Rescue Centre down in Pontypandy when they were waiting for Fireman Sam to arrive. Hey, Marshall, how do we get off here? Said Zuma to Marshall. And Chase said, He's right, how do we get off here, Marshall? Well, we have to wait for Fireman Sam, and Fireman Sam can make a call for you. So Fireman Sam came in on the Ocean Rescue jet ski, and he said, Hey guys, are you having fun on the Ocean Rescue Centre today? It's lots of fun, said Zuma, but it's time to go home now. Really? Where are you going? Said Sam. Well, we are going home to have some food, and Chase has got to get to the police station, and Marshall's got to get to the fire engine. Quick! Okay, so Fireman Sam makes a phone call, and he calls in Tom Thomas. Hey guys, said Tom Thomas, I've brought Neptune, the boat, so we can all jump on here. What a great idea, said Zuma. But would they all fit on Neptune, the ocean rescue boat? It's going to be a tight squeeze, but if you all hold on, it'll be just fine. So Marshall jumps on first, followed by Chase. And Chase said, Come on, Zuma, you can have the back where the engine is. It's the best spot of all. Oh, really? That'll be so cool. So we move the boat into position and Zuma jumps on. Hey guys, we're all on. Come on, it's time to go. Hold on tight, guys, said Tom Thomas to Marshall, Chase and Zuma as he headed off back to the Pontypandy land. Hey, you were right. We all did fit on in the end as well. I know, I'm always right. I wouldn't say the three could fit on if we can't. So they figured out how to get home off the Ocean Rescue Centre, so they can all get back to their normal daily jobs. Don't forget, guys, be safe out there, and don't forget to subscribe for more videos every day. See you next time. Hey Sam, what are we going to do today? Well, today we're going to take a look at this big Playmobil advent calendar for Christmas. Really? Wow, I wonder what's inside. Well, we can see on the box what's inside, said Officer Steele. That we can, said Naughty Norman. I can't wait to see what's inside this cool fireman's Playmobil advent calendar. So let's take a look at the box. We've got cool fire engines on the front. We got fire extinguishers, a motorbike. Wow, and it's so big, said Naughty Norman. So let's take a look on the back and see what's in there. Wow, look at that chainsaw in the middle. What do you guys like that's on the back of this advent calendar? So first of all, we need to get inside and take a look. And the first thing we got to do is build the playset and see what it's like. So let's build it and see what it looks like. Now it's built, we can see a workshop and some tires that's up in smoke. Fireman Sam, Naughty Norman and Officer Steel really like the playset. So come on guys, we need to find number one first. So let's see what's inside. There's number one, right in the middle. And what's inside? Cool! Is that a mechanic? It could be. It looks like. It definitely is a mechanic. So let's put the mechanic down and see if we can find number two. Can anyone see number two on the Playmobil calendar? I can see number two. There it is, right on the edge. Now let's see what's in there. Oh wow! Cool, we got some cool tools. We've got a hammer. Wow, that's really cool. What else is in there? We've got a spanner. These are all to go in a toolbox. We've also got an oil canister as well to fill the motorbike up, or we could fill the fire engines up with it. And we've also got a ratchet too. Wow. Great job. Now let's see if we can find number threes next. Hey Sam, do you like the tools? And Sam loves the tools. So does Officer Steel and Tom Thomas. So we found number three, it's right at the bottom. And in number three, we have a toolbox. Wow! We can put our tools that we found in number two in the toolbox. Right, it's time to find number four. Can anyone see number four? There it is, right on the top. And in number four, what do we have? We have a motorbike wheel and two bottles. I wonder what the bottles are used for. One's blue and one's yellow. And we add some stickers also. I wonder what they're for. So come on, it's time to find our next box, which is number five. There it is, right in the middle. Oh, cool. We've got a motorbike rider and a helmet. How cool is that? So let's put the helmet on the motorbike rider. Now we got to find the motorbike. Wow. Do you like the helmet, Sam?
Yes.
It'll definitely keep you safe if you fall off your bike. So let's take a look at number six and see what we find. Wow! We've got a motorbike in number six. That's pretty cool. Do you guys like the motorbike? Time to find number seven. Can anyone see number seven? Wow, it's this big one on the left hand side. Oh, cool. We've got some wood and some fire. That's pretty cool. Let's see. So let's put the fire on the wood and see what it looks like. It's one fire, two fires, three fires, four, five. There's five fires in total. Wow, that's amazing. Hey, be careful there. We don't want to set a fire off in this forest. Take it easy. So it's time to find number eight. Can anyone see? Number eight, there it is, right at the top. And let's see what it is. Oh, cool. A fire extinguisher. This is to put out fires with a little canister just like this. So now it's time to find number 9. Can anyone see number 9? It's this big one down the bottom. Oh, cool. We've got a firefighter. That's exactly what we need, is a firefighter to put out these fires. Oh, and he's also got a cool jacket also. So let's put the jacket on and see what he looks like. It's time to find number 10. Can anyone see number 10? Number 10's at the top. I wonder what we'll find. Cool. It's a helmet. So let's put the helmet on the guy to see what it looks like. Wow, that'll keep him safe in a fire, definitely. Right, it's time to find number 11. Wow, we got number 11. And what's inside? We seem to have some sort of pump of some description. It's a water pump. This is to let water out of the ground so we can put our fires out. Wow, good job. So let's put it together and see how it works. Good job, said Officer Steele. Officer Steele loves water pumps because that is how he gets his water. So let's open our next box and see what's inside. What do we have? Oh, cool. It's some sort of water gun with some sort of string. That's not string, said Officer Steele. That's the hose to put on the water. Really? So we can connect it up and we get water from the ground, just like so. So there it is, all connected up. And now, it's ready to be of use. Hey, Tom Thomas really likes our new hose and our new gun. Right, come on guys, let's find another one. What number are we looking for? Is it number 13? This big one down the bottom. Oh, cool. We got some cards, some playing cards. I wonder what pictures are on them. Let's take a look. They are some really cool playing cards. Right, come on, let's look for number 14 on the board and see what we can find. Can anyone see number 14? There it is at the top. And what is it? It's some sort of pump. I've never seen one of these before. Do you guys know what it is? So let's put it together and see how it works. It seems to be some sort of pump which goes up and down. So let's see if we can find number 15 on the board and see what it's like. There's number 15. Let's get inside and take a look. And I wonder what it is. It looks like... It's an axe. Wow, we got a big axe. And a small axe. Cool. Every firefighter needs an axe to chop down a door to get in there to save everyone. So now we're looking for number 16. Can anyone see number 16? There it is. Wow, more fire and more wood. Cool. Let's put the fire on the wood and see what it looks like. One fire, two fire, three fires on the wood. And this fire looks amazing. Sam doesn't like fire that much. He keeps putting it out all the time. So let's take a look at the next one, which is number 17. I wonder what we'll find in this one. Another firefighter. That's two firefighters in this advent calendar. Cool. So now we're looking for number 18. Can anyone see number 18? We found it, and it's another fire hat, or helmet, or cap. Depends how you say it. But it's another fire helmet, which will keep them safe in a fire. Come on, let's find the next one. I think we find the number 19 next. Can anyone see it? There it is, right at the top of the screen. What have we got? Oh, cool. We've got a backpack, an oxygen mask, to go on the back of the firefighter. Cool. And there it is on the firefighter. Let's open number 20. Wow! This is my favourite. The chainsaw. Cool. Let's put it on the firefighter so the firefighter can use it. Wow, look at that. Look how cool that is. That's my favourite so far. Hey, be careful with that chainsaw. Watch me. Oh, watch my helmet. No, no, don't cut my head off. I'm here to stay. Okay. We'll make up with a hug later. So it's time to find number 21 next. Anyone see number 21? There it is. Gotcha. This is a torch and a cool little laptop. That's really nice. So Sam can get to work on his computer. So next up is number 22. Can anyone see it? I can't see it. There it is, down the bottom. Oh, cool, we got a cat. A black cat. Can anyone name this cat for us? So let's take a look at number 23 next and see what we find. I wonder what's in Christmas Eve's box. Oh, cool. We got some sat-nav, some GPS, and a walkie-talkie. Now let's take a look at the big one, number 24 at the bottom. I wonder what we're going to get in here. Wow, look at that. It's massive. It's a big fire engine. But it's not like any fire engine. It's like a tractor fire engine with tractor wheels. That's pretty cool. So let's build this and see what it looks like. So don't forget, let us know in the comments below what was your favourite from this advent calendar. And again, don't forget to subscribe, like always. See you next time.
One snowy day, outside with the police lorry, a police officer started a fire to keep warm because it was so cold and so snowy. He just couldn't stay warm in the van. So he lit the fire next to the van, which was a big mistake. And the van started to go up in flames. But slowly, but surely, the van was going up fast. But he phones for help. And eventually, Chase comes round and said, "Oh no, what have you done? You've put the van in a dangerous situation. And now it's on fire. Oh no. We better call for some professional assistance," said Chase. "But who could we call?" said the policeman. "There's only two people I trust to take on this job. And that is our trusty Fireman Sam and Peppa Pig. So in they come in the Lego fire engine with a Lego fire officer. And they said, wow, we need to get this fire out of the way. So the Lego man climbs up and starts putting the fire out. Great job, said Sam. We'll work with the small ones and then work to the big ones. And in no time at all, we put the first fire out. And then they started working on the second one. And then the third, as Fireman Sam moves the fire that the policeman made out of the way. Eventually they got around to the last and final fire that was on the police lorry. And they managed to put it out, saving the really expensive police lorry. And the policeman couldn't believe how silly he was by placing the fire too close to the van. And Sam said, you need to think about where you're placing fires in future. Because putting it next to anything, whether it's a van, tree, shop, it's always a dangerous situation to be in. But Peppa said, at least everyone's safe, Sam. And we've done our good deed for the day. Chase was here to make sure everything was fine. And along with Fireman Sam, Peppa Pig, and the new Lego fire officer, they all worked as a team to put it out. Don't forget to subscribe. Fireman Sam, Marshall, and Tom Thomas were all at the Pontypandy fire station. And they were just about to do some work on the 4x4 when some of their best friends came round, which was George Pig. And George said, hey guys, as he sniffed Marshall. And Marshall said, what are you sniffing me for? You smell really good, said George. Where's Naughty Norman? Asked Fireman Sam. Oh, here he is now. Hey guys, Naughty Norman said, how is everyone? And Tom Thomas said, we are just fine, Naughty Norman. How are you? We are great, said Norman and George. So what are you guys up to today? Asked George and Norman. Well, we're going to work on the 4x4. Really? What are you going to do to it? We're going to clean it. We're going to check the wheels. And we're also going to make sure the sirens are working. Because come and look, we just cleaned the helicopter. Wow, said Norman. It's looking super clean. Could you take me out in it? Asked Norman. And Sam said, oh, I can't right now, Norman. You'll have to wait. But Norman doesn't like waiting. So George and Marshall had just watched everyone going over to the 4x4. So once they were cleaning and working on the 4x4, George and Norman were left alone. This was dangerous, because we don't know what Norman and George would do on their own. When Norman jumped into the helicopter, and he said, come on, George, and to jump back in. But I think it's safer for George to stay with Sam today. And Daddy Pig said, I don't know what happened, Sam. I just lost control. Maybe I need to drive a lot slower for a little bit, and then I can drive faster when I know how to drive. But he said, thanks, Sam. I'll see you again. So Sam was going to look after George today, and he'd take him back to Peppa Pig's house. But at least Zuma and Sam had saved the day again. Don't forget to subscribe, said George. Oh no! The police station's on fire! But as PC Selby pulled up, he couldn't believe how much the fire had grown. Oh no, I better phone for help. So he jumps out of his police car and he goes off, and he said, I better phone Fireman Sam and Peppa Pig to sort this out. And he goes, quick, quick, Peppa, Sam, I need you. So he phoned for help from the Pontypandy fire crew, Fireman Sam, and they came straight over. Wow, that was so quick. Peppa jumped out and said, Sam, you jump in the driver's seat and reverse up, and I'll climb up the ladder. So as Sam released the ladder onto the roof, Peppa said, good job, Sam. Now I can go up on top of the roof and start putting the fire out. So Peppa climbs on top of the ladder, with a great struggle, and she fights the flames all on her own. Wow! Good job, Peppa, said PC Selby. Go on, Sam. We can do the next fire now. So Sam reverses onto the next fire. So fire number two, better watch out. So Peppa got to work. Wow. Good job, that's the second fire out. Now it's time for the third fire. So they head over and Sam reverses onto the roof. Good job, Sam. You're perfect. I can take the two fires off at once. Good job. So Peppa climbs up the ladder and she tries tackling the bigger fire of the two. Wow. And she takes it down. And it was just one fire to go. Wow. Good job. She said, all done, Sam. You can pull away now. And PC Selby was relieved as he said, I'm so happy you guys came so fast to put this fire out. I couldn't have done it without you. Look at all this fire, said Sam and Peppa. Great job, Peppa. You really did us proud. And PC Selby was over the moon. So you can always count on Fireman Sam and Peppa Pig to put the fire out if you call them. Don't forget to subscribe, said Peppa. Fireman Sam, Tom Thomas, and Peppa Pig were at the fire station when Peppa said, Fireman Sam, it's been really quiet today. And all of a sudden, the bell goes, and she said, oh no. Now it's time to get into action, said Fireman Sam. So Tom Thomas answers the phone, and he shouted out to Fireman Sam and Peppa Pig, it's Gotham City. It's on fire. We need to go and save it quickly. I think we'll need the two, Jupiter and Venus, for this job. So Fireman Sam and Peppa Pig both jump into Jupiter, the fire engine. And Fireman Sam says, come on, Peppa, let's go. Oh no, Peppa fell out. Come on, Peppa, get back in. Don't be silly. So Jupiter heads off to Gotham City. Now Tom Thomas needs to jump into Venus quickly, so he can help out with the fire. Oh no, Tom Thomas said, let's go. So Tom Thomas loves Venus. So he jumps into Venus and off he goes. Let's go. Let's save Gotham City, said Tom Thomas. So in comes Fireman Sam and Peppa Pig to Gotham City. And Peppa said, this is quite serious, Fireman Sam. It's definitely going to take two vehicles to put it out. So Peppa Pig jumps into the hose position and Fireman Sam raises Peppa up into position to start fighting the fire. So meanwhile, Tom Thomas comes in and said, wow, this is worse than I thought. So Tom Thomas jumps out and he jumps on top of Venus to use the hose. So he sits down and he points the hose at the lower fire. So Peppa's going to do the top fire and Tom Thomas is going to keep control of the fire on the bottom so it doesn't spread. So Peppa manages to put out one lot of fire. She's on to the second lot. Great job, Fireman Sam, said Peppa, Just one more lot now up here, and we're done. Great job. Peppa said, oh look, Tom Thomas is struggling to keep control of the fire on the bottom. I think he needs help. So let's get the hose out, said Peppa. And we'll hose down as well as using Venus. So with a helping hand, we pull out the hose from the side of Jupiter. And together, Peppa Pig and Tom Thomas and Venus will put the fire out on the bottom of Gotham City. When there's two people working as a team, it's definitely easier to put the fire out. And Fireman Sam has done a great job of directing Jupiter so it doesn't get burned as well. So finally the fire's out, but there's still a lot of mess to clear up. And Tom Thomas said, great job, Peppa. Thanks for helping me. And Peppa said, that's fine. We're a team. So with a helping hand, we clear up the mess. And Tom Thomas falls over, just going to prove how dangerous it can be even after the fire is gone. So Fireman Sam jumps out of Jupiter, and finally they can all relax. The fire's put out, it's all under control. And Fireman Sam said, good work team. We definitely worked as a team on this one. Now the prisoners can be put in Gotham City where they belong. Don't forget to subscribe, said Peppa. Right guys, just got a little two-pack of Fireman Sam surprise figures to see what we get. So let's get stuck in and see what happens. See who we get. You have to use the scissors on these ones if you do go out and buy them, because they are foil bags. First of all, I'll just show you what characters we can get in there. Fireman Sam, which we got. Elvis, we need to get Elvis. We got Station Officer Steel. Dillis, we haven't got. We need to get her. Mike Flood, we got. Naughty Norman, we need to get. And Tom, we've already got. So, let's see who we've got in the first packet. And we've got Naughty Norman. So, yeah, he's pretty good. You know, his head moves. His arms move as well. His legs don't move, but that's okay. That's probably a good thing for Naughty Norman, because he's up to all naughty stuff all the time. So let's go into the second packet. And we got the same little catalogue. And we've got another Mike Flood. So yeah guys, I'm glad we got Naughty Norman finally, because you can't come across him that much. And hope you enjoyed this little two-pack surprise opening. And for all you Fireman Sam lovers out there, hope you enjoy your Easter. Thanks for watching.
Elvis. Now let's take a closer look and make sure it's our Elvis from Fireman Sam. There he is, and we grabbed him by the hat. How cool was that? Let's give it another go and see who we get. Get in there. We got Fireman Sam, and we grabbed him by the hat again. How cool was that? Now let's take another look and see who else we can get. This time we got the Ocean Rescue Fireman Sam, and this one is the one that goes on the sea because he's got his life jacket on and his hat to stay safe. Let's see who we can find next.
More coins.
Yes, it's one of our favourite characters from Pontopandi, Mike Flood, and we grabbed him by the hand. How cool was that? So let's see who we can get next. I wonder who it'll be.
Yeah.
Yes, it's our favourite character, Peppa Pig, with a fire suit on, ready to get to rescuing. So let's see if we can rescue Naughty Norman from inside the machine.
Whoa, we got Officer Steel. Cool.
We all love Officer Steel from the fire engine in Pontopandi. He loves his fire engines, just like us. So let's see who we get next.
Ah!
finally got Naughty Norman. Now come on, let's rescue Nurse Flood, who's last, as we can see. And let's get to work. Finally, we got Nurse Flood. So that means we've emptied the grabber, and now it's time to take a look at everyone that we found. We got everyone from the Pontopandi fire station. Wow. If you like this video, don't forget to like and subscribe. I'll see you next time.
Why don't you take the 4x4 out and see how Pontopandi's doing? Peppa said, I'd love to go out. Who's going to drive? Are you coming, Fireman Sam, or shall Tom Thomas take me out? Tom Thomas steps forward and says, we'll go out together, Peppa, but we need to get the 4x4 out of the garage first. So the 4x4 comes out to the garage so Tom Thomas and Peppa can get inside. So Tom Thomas jumps in the driver's seat. And Peppa said, come on, Thomas, I can't wait to go for a drive. I'm really excited. So then Peppa walks over, jumps on the board and said, come on, Thomas, start the engine up. So Tom Thomas started the engine. And Peppa gets in. Peppa can be silly sometimes, and she jumps on top of the engine. So Tom Thomas and Peppa Pig are now ready to see if there's any trouble in Pontopandi. So they go off to do their job for the day. So that leaves Fireman Sam on his own in the fire station, ready in case there's any fires anywhere else. So after closing the doors, Fireman Sam can just relax, wait for a phone call or emergency to come in. In his spare time, Fireman Sam always likes to sit down outside the garage and take in the view. Sometimes in life it's nice just to relax. Don't forget to subscribe. The special delivery. Fireman Sam and Peppa Pig have just finished cleaning Fireman Sam's truck. Peppa said, Fireman Sam, we've done a great job today cleaning the truck. It's looking really clean. So Fireman Sam does a few checks. So he goes around the fire engine just to make sure it's up to standard, because you can't drive around in a dirty truck. Oh, we did a great job, said Fireman Sam. So Fireman Sam just remembered, we've got a special delivery coming today, Peppa. Do you want to stay around to see what it is? So Peppa said, yeah, I'd love to. So Fireman Sam and Peppa Pig waited for Postman Pat to arrive with the special delivery. Here's Postman Pat now, said Fireman Sam. So Postman Pat and Jess are on time as always. So Jess jumps out of the van and quickly goes and sees Peppa. And Peppa said, hey Jess, I'm really happy to see you. I didn't realize he was coming today. So Postman Pat gets out of the van and he's really excited and he falls over. He's so excited to see Peppa Pig and Fireman Sam. And he says, hey guys, how are you? Here's your special delivery. So Postman Pat brings special delivery for Fireman Sam. And he said, oh, will you open it now while I'm here? Said Postman Pat. So Peppa and Fireman Sam are really happy that the special delivery is on time. So Fireman Sam said to Peppa, "You can open it, so with a helping hand." Peppa opens the surprise delivery. "Wow," said Peppa, "you've got a cool toy car." "It's a Porsche," said Peppa. And Fireman Sam said, "Yeah, I'm collecting them now. I've got a few others to collect. But how cool is that?" So Peppa goes over and has a closer look and says, "The detail is really nice on it, Fireman Sam." So Fireman Sam, Peppa Pig, Postman Pat all get to see Fireman Sam's new toy car. What a cool car it is. "Don't forget to subscribe," said Peppa. Postman Pat and Jess were just at their new sorting office, and they've also got a new van to go with their sorting office. At the sorting office, they sort out all the parcels, letters and forms for Pontypandy and the village. They're just waiting on Fireman Sam and Peppa Pig to turn up, and they're going to have a look around. Jess said, "Where are they, Postman Pat?" Pat said, "Be calm. Here they come now." So in comes Fireman Sam and Peppa Pig. And Peppa said, "Wow, look at the size on Postman Pat's new van. Let's get out and have a look." So Fireman Sam and Peppa Pig get out of the helicopter to have a look and say to Postman Pat, "Wow, look at this place, Pat. It's huge." And Pat said, "I know, I'm really happy with it." So with a helping hand, the door's held up while Postman Pat goes in to have a look. Once inside, Postman Pat, Fireman Sam and Peppa Pig can all see the amount of letters, parcels and everything else that needs to be sorted in this sorting office. "And it's got a cool little hatch," said Jess. "Look at this little hatch. Watch me now." Jess always likes to mess about, especially in work time. So Jess comes flying down the little slide and hits Peppa on the head. Peppa said, "Oh, Jess, you're such a silly little cat." So Fireman Sam said, "Come on, Postman Pat. Show us this new van of yours. It looks really cool." So Postman Pat moved the van so Peppa and Fireman Sam could look at it properly. Jess is always messing about, so Jess jumped inside. And Fireman Sam said, "Wow, this is really going to help deliver more parcels quickly around the village. And Pontypandy won't be short of packages this week." And Sam said, "Are you happy with your Postman Pat?" And Pat said, "I really like my little van. It's going to be hard to leave my little van go." And Peppa said, "There's no need to leave it go. You can just use the two of them." So Fireman Sam and Peppa Pig headed off to see PC Selby next, leaving Postman Pat and Jess to get on with their day's work doing their special deliveries. Jess said, "Don't forget to subscribe." The tea party. Fireman Sam, Peppa Pig, Grandad Dog and Postman Pat and George all came round to see Grandma. And she's got a really cool Peppa Pig tea set to pour some tea into. So Jess is having a look around. There's no tea in there, she sees. So Grandma says, "There's no tea in there yet, so I'll pour some tea in there now." So with a helping hand, the tea is poured into the Peppa Pig cups, one by one, until all four cups are full. "Who should go first?" said Peppa. So Grandma checks all the tea is in the cups. And Peppa comes over and says, "Wow, great job, Grandma." So Fireman Sam comes forward and chooses his chosen cup. Who's next? Postman Pat's next. Which cups is Postman Pat gonna pick? So Postman Pat goes over with Jess to pick the furthest cup. Oh, Jess is getting stuck in already. Wow. So Grandad Dog comes over and squeezes in between Postman Pat and Fireman Sam. So who's next? It's George. George is next. George nearly jumps in the cup. So it's just Peppa Pig to come now. So Peppa comes over and stands by her cup. So Grandma said, "You can all start drinking now if you want. It's a tea party." So Postman Pat, Fireman Sam, Grandad Dog, Peppa Pig and George were all treated to a tea party by Grandma. And they're all enjoying their tea. "Don't forget to subscribe," said Peppa. Hey guys, welcome to another surprise video. Today we're going to open two packs, one from Fireman Sam and one from the Power Rangers Samurai. And let's take a little look at the Power Rangers one first. And as you can see, it says Power Rangers Cool Treat Collectibles. There's 12 to collect. And as you can see on the back, these are the 12 you want to collect. Now I'd like to have this gold one. Or the blue one. Gold or blue would be really nice if we could get one of them. But let's take a little look what else is in here, because it feels like there's other things in here rather than just surprises. So let's see what else we get. So first things first, we have a load of stickers, which is really cool. Yeah, that's really nice. So as you can see, they stickers. So you just take them off and let's just put them there. Got all the characters on there as well, which is really nice. So let's take a little look at what we get in here. So we've got the yellow head, which I think they display at Dumbs, because I think six of them are actually for display, and I think six are like key rings sort of thing. So let's just take a little look. Let's get her head out of there. So yeah, as you can see, the six pencil toppers, or bag clips, they're called. So we've just got a pencil topper, so you've got the hole there. But that's pretty cool, and some jelly beans, which is really nice. So let's take a little look at the Fireman Sam collectible. I haven't opened one of these for a while. I opened one of these a while ago now, so let's take a little look. It's got all the characters on the front there, which is really nice. It's a cool little bag, actually, you know, as a little gift or something to someone. And it, you know, the figures in them are really detailed. So let's just take a quick look at the list. So as you can see, we got Fireman Sam, Elvis, Station Officer Steel, Dillis, Mike Flood, Norman, and Tom Thomas. So which one would I prefer to have? I'd like to have Mike Flood, which is, there he is. But yeah, that'd be cool. But we'll see who we have. And we have none other than Fireman Sam himself. Hello. So yeah, as you can see, they're really well detailed as well. You know, they've got articulated legs and arms as well, which is really nice. So you can, you know, they're meant to be played with the sets you can buy. So that's pretty cool. So yeah guys, let me know in the comments below what's your favorite surprise from this video. As always guys, thanks for watching. If you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe, comment and like and all that good stuff. Hope everyone's having a fantastic day, and I'll see you next time.
Oh no, it looks like a claw's come out to take out the Pontapandy fire crew with Fireman Sam and the rest of his crew. But oh no, it's just a rescue claw from the new Fireman Sam range. Now, this claw can be used in all rescues. To pick up cars, to pick up boats, to pick up even the Pontypandy fire station, if you need to. Just like this. So we pick up Neptune. So let's try to pick up Tom Thomas and Fireman Sam. So let's pick up Jupiter as well, to see if we can pick up one of the best fire engines in the world. And then we'll take a closer look at how it works. So Jupiter, come here. So we pick up Jupiter, as easy as that. And as you can see, the claw is mighty strong, which can pick up anything from the fireman range. So let's take a look closer look at the actual rescue claw itself to see how it works. So as you can see, it's got some really great detail on the front of it. The claws close just like this. We've got some really nice bolts which make it look real, and it basically works off a little arm on the back which attaches to your arm, and it can be used as a claw just like your fingers, which is really cool. So if you guys like this new Fireman Rescue Claw, don't forget to subscribe for more videos.
The time has come once again for Fireman Sam to do his daily checks on his fire helicopter. Now, he does these checks once a day, so this will give us a chance to take a look at the rescue helicopter. We've got a big spotlight down the bottom, two little indicators. We've got yellow propellers, which people can see from a mile away. We've got a winch on the side, which can pull people up in an emergency. We've also got some yellow feet, which come in handy to land on the ocean when he needs to land on water, which is really cool. So you let us know, what do you like about this helicopter? And do you have this helicopter in your Fireman Sam playset?
Elvis was at the lifeboat station all alone. So he thought, let's check if the work had been done for the day. So he went over to the computer to have a look. Oh, nothing here. But there was a note on the computer to say that the alarm needed to be checked. So Elvis went up the stairs to check on the fire alarm. Oh, this looks great, he said. But there's one outside that he needed to check as well. And as he went outside, he checked the alarm. Everything was working just fine. But oh no, Elvis said, how am I going to get down now? So Elvis shouted for help. Silly Elvis had managed to get himself stuck on the balcony outside on the lifeboat station. But fear not, Sam was coming in soon. Oh no, Elvis, Sam said. How are you stuck out there? Oh, I was just checking the alarm, and I just got stuck on the balcony. Now I can't get back down. As Tom Thomas came in on another Neptune. Wow, Elvis said. Two Neptunes? We are spoilt for choice in this lifeboat station. Of course, Sam said. Elvis, this is one of the best lifeboat stations in the world. I'll get you down now. So Fireman Sam reversed up to the lifeboat station and he said, right, Elvis, you have to jump onto the balcony, onto the back of my boat, and then jump behind me, and you'll be safe. But Elvis was scared. But Tom Thomas said, go on, jump. So he jumps onto the back of Neptune, and down he went. Go on, jump. And he jumps. See, Elvis, you're safe after all. You had nothing to worry about. Oh, thanks, Sam. And Tom Thomas, you really saved me today. I'm so silly. Right, let's get back inside, said Sam. So they headed back in, and they managed to get Elvis safe and sound back into the lifeboat station where he belongs. You didn't even have your life jacket on, Elvis. Oh, I know, Sam. I'm really sorry. I just wanted to check the alarm for you to save you the job. I know, Sam said. You wanted to save me the job, but by you being nice, you managed to get yourself into trouble. Oh, never mind, Tom Thomas said. I'm sure you've learned your lesson now, Elvis. I most certainly have. I'll make sure I put my life jacket on from now on. So Elvis learned a valuable lesson today, So if he's going to help people out and do jobs for them, he has to wear the right equipment for the right job. But at least everyone's safe. That's the main thing. Don't forget to subscribe, said Sam. Fireman Sam and Zuma were at the lifeboat station, and they had just finished having a hard day's work. When out of nowhere, they hear a big crash and something hit the lifeboat station. So Sam rushes to the door and goes to look outside, but he can't get outside. There's something stopping him getting outside. So he jumps into Neptune, and Zuma says, "Come on, Sam, let's go." So they head off to drive around the lifeboat station to see what's outside and what's crashed into the boat house. What would it be? Oh no, it's only Daddy Pig and George, and he was in his speedboat, so he must have crashed into his lifeboat station with his new speedboat. Oh no, Zuma said. Are you guys safe? They are now, said Sam. We are here. So Sam tries to help up George and said, "Come on, George, grab on." So George grabs Sam's hand. So Sam pulled him up. And now it was time to help Daddy Pig. So he said, "Come on, Daddy Pig, jump on." Azuma made sure Daddy Pig didn't drown. So Daddy Pig jumps up really quick onto Neptune. So it was up to Zuma to try to get the speedboat back upright. I wonder how Zuma will do it. "Great job, Sam," said Daddy Pig. "You really saved me and George today." So Zuma tries to get the speedboat back upright and off the lifeboat station. And he just gives it a gentle nudge. And now it was time for Daddy Pig to jump back